Hello everyone, the Snowman here, and today I wanted to explain what exactly the National Tennis Rating Program ranking system is and how they are used. Basically, if you don't already know your tennis ranking as a player, then hopefully after this video you should be able to place yourself into one of the categories. This program though, the NTRP, is meant to help all tennis players enjoy the sport of tennis more by providing a method of classifying skill levels for more compatible matches, group lessons, league play, tournaments, other programs. Basically, with this system, it's able to place players at all levels, whether it's casual, junior, collegiate, semi-pro, professional. It places them into a specific numbered group. And then that way, you know, it's a consistent, uniform ranking system, and things are more even and fun for the sport of tennis. A few guidelines: the rating categories are skill level generalizations, so you may not fit perfectly into one of these categories. Also, you can, of course, move up or down in terms of the numbers, depending on how your skill level changes throughout your life. Maybe you're in your 20s right now, you're starting off as a 2.5 or a 3. That's only gonna go up, though, as your skills get better, you sharpen the tools, and you play more tennis. It's important players are honest when evaluating their skill level, just for the fairness of competition. If you're unsure where you fall, err on the side of the higher level of play. It'll just be more fair in the long run. And if you want to play in real USTA leagues, you must have an NTRP rating. So that's why it's very important. So let's dive into the groupings. And right now we're going to determine what is your NTRP ranking. So for the different playing levels, it is a scale of 1.5 to 7. We start with 1.5, the lowest on the list. These players have limited experience, and they're still working primarily on just getting the ball into play. The 2.0 grouping then, these players need more on-court experience. This player has obvious stroke weaknesses, but is familiar with basic positions for both singles and doubles play. 2.5, this player is learning to judge where the ball is going. Although court coverage is pretty weak, can sustain a short rally of slow pace with other players of the same ability. 3.0, this player fairly consistent when hitting medium pace shots, but is not comfortable with all strokes and lacks execution when trying for directional control, depth, or power. 3.5, now this player has achieved improved stroke dependability with directional control on moderate shots, still lacks some depth and variety. This player exhibits more aggressive net play, has improved court coverage, and is developing teamwork in doubles. 4.0, this is pretty much where I fall on this spectrum. This player has dependable strokes, including directional control and depth on both forehand and backhand sides on moderate shots, plus the ability to use lobs, overheads, approach shots, and volleys with some success. This player occasionally forces errors when serving. Rallies may be lost due to impatience, and teamwork in doubles is evident as well. 4.5, this player has begun to master the use of power and spins, and is beginning to handle pace, has sound footwork, can control depth of shots, and is beginning to vary game plan according to opponents. This player can hit first serves with power and accuracy and placement with the second serve. This player tends to hit very difficult shots. Aggressive net play is common in doubles too. The 5.0 player has good shot anticipation, frequently has an outstanding shot or a highlight. This player can regularly hit winners or force errors off of short balls and can put away volleys. Can successfully execute lobs, drop shots, half volleys, overhead smashes, and has good depth and spin on most second serves. Just a couple more now. 5.5, this player has developed power and consistency as a major weapon. This player can vary strategies and styles of play in a competitive situation and hits dependable shots in a stress situation, so the clutch factor there now as well. And then 6.0 to 7.0, the 6.0 player typically has had intensive training for national tournament competition at the junior and collegiate levels and has obtained a sectional or national ranking, and the 7.0 player is a world-class player. They're probably on the ATP or WTA tour. All right, so thank you so much for watching. Hopefully this video was informative for you. If you didn't already know what your ranking was, hopefully now you're able to place yourself into one of these rankings and continue to keep playing tennis. But thanks a lot for watching. If you enjoyed this video or found it helpful, please subscribe to the Snowman Sports Media. Give me a thumbs up, and I'll be back very soon. Thanks a lot. Cheers.